I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, I've got no roots.
First and foremost, the objectives of the experiment are to investigate the functional relationship between the height of fall and falling time. Next, at the end of the experiment, we will be able to determine the acceleration due to gravity by studying the motion of a freely moving object. So, the apparatus needed for this experiment are falling sphere apparatus consisting of release unit, impact switch, digital counter, body kits, support base, right angle clamp, plate holder, meter scale, support rod, connecting rod, and ball bearing.
Next is the procedure for this experiment. Firstly, apparatus set up as in figure 3.1. An electricity conducting sphere is gripped in the release mechanism, which closes the start circuit. Secondly, pen is adjusted by using the adjusting screw under the arrest switch, so a downward motion of a few tenths of a millimeter closes the stop circuit. Pen is raised by hand every single measurement, that is initial position. Thirdly, to effectively determine the height of the fall, using the marking on the release mechanism, the sphere radius must be taken into account, that is diameter 3 over 4 inch, approximately 19 millimeter. The aerodynamic drag of the sphere can be disregarded. By following the procedure, we will get the result. We managed to tabulate the height of the fall and the time taken for the ball to reach the ground. For each height, we repeat the step for 3 times to get the average height.
Hello, my name is Khairul Nizwanizam, and this is the analysis for experiment 3. The first graph is height of fall as a function of falling time, and the second graph is height of fall as a function of the square of falling time. Next, we need to find the gradient of the graph, which is height of fall as a function of the square of falling time graph. So as we know, the formula to find slope is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So we enter the value and we'll get this. And in this experiment, the slope are equal to 1 over 2 g square. So in order to calculate the value g, we need to enter the slope value. So at the end of the calculation, we will get the 20 meter per second second.
Hey, hello. So I will be continuing the analysis for this experiment. So the third one is actually to calculate the value of uncertainties of G. So first of all, we will get the M1 and M2 value, and after getting these two value, we will have M1 minus it with M2, and then we will divide with 2. So after dividing with 2, you will get the answer, and the uncertainties of G is actually 5.45 meter per second square. For the part 4, so we have to calculate the percent difference between the value of G calculated in part 1 that was explained by Khairul just now above the G experiment, and the standard value of G standard, which is 9.81 meter per second square. So the question is that, what is the percent error in this experimental value? So to find percent error, you will take the G standard, which is 9.81 meter per second square, and then you will divide it with 20, which is the value that we get in the G just now that was explained by Khairul, and then you will times it with 100, and then you will get 49%. So this 49% is the percent error for this experimental value. So for the last part of this analysis is that, is there any experimental errors? Discuss. So there are actually several types of experimental error that can occur when measuring gravitational acceleration, including the first one is that human error can happen when the experimenter mistakes, such as misreading a measurement or losing equipment. For precautions, it is crucial to have clear procedure in place for the experiment and for the researcher to strictly adhere to them in order to prevent human error. Additionally, it can be helpful to spot any potential error to have a second person review measurement and calculations. So second one is that a measuring inaccuracy known as parallax error can occur when the observer's line of sight is not perfectly parallel to the measurement. For precautions, to avoid this, make sure that the measurement and the observer line of sight are exactly aligned. A sighting or bubble level can be used to align the measurement tool in this manner. So the third one, which is the last one, is that error resulting from improper handling or processing of data might provide findings that are error or inconsistent. For precautions, it is crucial to establish a clear and well-documented system for managing and evaluating data if you want to avoid data processing error. This entails labeling data files appropriately and making sure that data is entered accurately into any analytic tools. Additionally, having a second person review the data process. So we have come to an end of this part of the video, which is the gravitational accelerations. So before we move on to the next part of this video, which is the ballistic pendulum, it would be nice for me to conclude everything for this experiment. So based on the results and analysis of these investigations, we can draw the conclusion that an object's mass has no bearing on the velocity at which it falls based on the findings and analysis of this inquiry. When falling from the same height as it does in free fall, the object will always have the same velocity. This is because air resistance is not taken into account and the Earth's gravity pulls on it. That is all from us. Thank you. Please enjoy the next part of our video, which is on the ballistic pendulum.
Hello, it's Paloma again. Now, let's proceed to our next presentation, which is experiment 4, ballistic pendulum.
Hello and greetings everyone. So today, I would love to introduce to you our group member. So first and foremost, it would be nice for me to introduce myself first. Hi again, my name is Adriana Cheryl, and three of my friends are Paloma Abby, Regina Ederly, and last but not least, the only guy in our group is Khairun Iswanizam. So the four of us will be talking or explaining more about the experiment 3 and 4 that we have done during our lab class.
That is so all from this experiment.
Thank you.
Please enjoy
pendulum.
The next part
there
of our video, which is on the ballistic
talk to
pendulum.
You about or explain to you our findings. So first, we have the objective, the paratest, the procedure, the results, the analysis, the discussion, and last but not least, the conclusion.
Hello, assalamualaikum. My name is Khairun Iswanizam Ijamirin, and this is the objective for experiment for ballistic pendulum. The objective are to determine the velocity of a metal ball fired from a spring-loaded gun ballistic pendulum. Next are the apparatus that needed for this experiment. The apparatus that needed for this experiment are ballistic pendulum apparatus and meter ruler.
These are the procedure for this experiment. So firstly, the set screw that holds the pendulum at the top of the apparatus will be unscrewed, and then the mass of the ball and mass of the ball with the pendulum together will be taken, and then the apparatus will be reassembled, and then the pendulum is checked if it can swing freely with a minimum of side-to-side motion, and then the gun will be fired carefully. Listen, the keyword is carefully. So then, the height of the ball which trapped in the catcher will be measured by using a ruler from the base of the apparatus. Next, the data will be tabulated in table 5.1, and then steps 3 to 5 are repeated until 10 readings of height are obtained. And then after that, the value of the U for each value of H calculated by using the equation shown in the slide, and then the average value of U and its uncertainties is calculated from the 10 values calculated in step 9.
Alright, now let's move on to the results that we obtained. The mass of the metal ball, which is small letter m, is equals to 0.0035 with the uncertainties of 0.0001 kilogram, whereas the mass of the pendulum catcher, the capital letter M, is equals to 0.078 with the uncertainties of 0.001 kilogram. So this is how we obtain the initial velocity U by using this equation. So for the first reading, we obtain the height of 0.180 and the initial velocity is 43.76 meter per second. The second reading with the height of 0.140 meter, the initial velocity is equals to 38.59 meter per second. The third reading with the height of 0.110, the initial velocity is equals to 34.21 meter per second. The fourth reading, we obtain the height 0.130 with the initial velocity 37.18 meter per second. The fifth reading, we obtain from the height, which is 0.080 meter with the initial velocity of 29.17 meter per second. The sixth reading, which is height, is equals to 0.110 and the initial velocity is 34.21 meter per second. As for the seventh reading, we obtain the same as the sixth reading. As for the eighth and ninth reading, we obtain the same height and initial velocity, which is 0.100 and the initial velocity is 32.66. And for the last reading, we obtain the height 0.105 meter and the initial velocity is 33.45 meter per second. So in all, the average of initial velocity is 32.01 meter per second.
Analysis calculation. First, calculate the average initial velocity of metal ball fired from a spring-loaded gun of ballistic pendulum and its uncertainties. To calculate the average U or initial velocity, we sum up all the result of velocity and divide it with 2. By doing this, we manage to get the average U of 32.01 meter per second. To calculate the uncertainties, we subtract the highest value of velocity with the lowest one and divide it with 2. By doing this, we will get the uncertainties of plus minus 7 meter per second. Second, state the two physical principles used to determine the initial velocity of metal ball in this experiment. The first one is energy conservation and the second one is momentum conservation.
All in all, we managed to determine the initial velocity of a metal ball that is fired through a spring-loaded ballistic pendulum. As we repeated the process for 10 more times, we obtained the average value of the initial velocity U by using equation U is equal to the mass of the ball plus mass of the ball together with the pendulum divided by mass of the ball times square root of 2 times gravitational acceleration times height of each metal ball that is fired, whereby g, gravitational acceleration, is equals to 9.81 meter per second. The average initial velocity that we obtain is 32.01 meter per second.
And that's all from us. Thank you.